Hey everyone, it's Mike from WordPress.com. We recently launched some new designs and a new flow to make it super easy to set up a link in bio site. A lot of people still ask, what's a link in bio site? So this started as a trend when Instagram started picking up more and more users, but Instagram doesn't allow you to put a link in your posts. So people are used to social networks allowing you to put a link in there so you can drive traffic back to your site. That wasn't allowed on Instagram because they wanted to focus on visual content. They do allow you to put one link in your bio. So people got smart and started making sure that one link went to a page that connected to all their content, all the different things they had going on, so that as they're posting about different things, they could send their followers to that one link, or their link in bio, to find the content that they're interested in or looking for. So it's a really basic idea. The designs are pretty simple to start off with. You can launch, like just change the content and go. But there's some really cool things that you can do that not a lot of people know about to make it stand out, to reach kind of different goals that you may have as a creator or a business, and to kind of grow your audience a little bit more. So I'm going to focus on those. So I chose a design. I set up a new site. This thing's ready to go if I want it to be. But the first thing I want to do is make the design stand out a little bit more. So you'll notice that the buttons, the image, and the text are all pretty static and basic. Nothing fancy, and the background is kind of where the flair is coming from in this design, which is fine. It's built inside the cover block, and so I'm going to take a look at that, and I'm going to replace that background. Instead of using a photo and just making another static image, I'm actually going to try a video and see how that looks. So that's pretty cool. Now we have some motion that brings whoever's looking at the page back to it and kind of keeps them engaged a little bit more. If I go into settings, I can play around with this. And so there's an overlay that makes the background a little bit darker or lighter, depending on what you do, so that the text in front of it is easier to read. So I can make it darker if it's too distracting, or I can make it lighter if I want it to stick out a little bit more. I can also kind of use this overlay to apply some different styles to it. Now, the Aurora Borealis is pretty colorful by itself, but if I make something like a red gradient, the overlay, and I increase the opacity a little bit to make it more prominent, you still get that cool Aurora effect with kind of a different tint or filter feel over top of it. So that's pretty cool. That makes the page look a lot more interesting and a lot more engaging without having to do hardly anything to it. Video backgrounds can be found on Pexels. We have an integration with Pexels for images. If you want the videos, you need to go to Pexels, P-E-X-E-L-S.com, and search for videos there. You can also Google other free videos that are you can use and see what other resources you come up with. So the background makes a big difference in terms of how everything looks. Obviously, you can dive into styles and tweak all the fonts and everything to make the overall look and feel match more of what you're going for. But let's do something else. Let's assume that I am not just a person trying to drive traffic to those buttons on my page. Let's assume I'm, say, a video creator, and I want to get more views to a specific video that I released recently. Now, an easy way to do this is to just grab the video URL from YouTube or whatever your platform is, and to just paste it. And when you do that, it's automatically gonna fit that video and embed it into the content area that I put it in. So for now, I put it inside the group. Over here, you can see that in the list view, and it's right under my site title. So if my most important goal is to get views, I put this video above my buttons and we're good to go. Now, if my goal or my most important goal is to build a bigger social audience, what I might do instead is focus on connecting people to my other social accounts and make those more obvious or more attractive than just my button links. If you type in social icons, we actually have a block for that and it keeps all of the updated icons available. So we can do this, we can add WordPress, we can add Facebook, we can add TikTok, and let's say something like YouTube. And then in the settings, you can really control how these look and feel. So when you select social icons overall, then you can choose the shape, the logos only kind of thing, or the default gives the logos a little bit of a background so they're easier to see. You can choose to open them in a new tab so that that person who's looking at it still has your link in bio site up, but they're able to connect with you on those social channels. You can choose the icon colors. So say if I wanted to go with something a little bit more green, I want to make the background maybe blue. That's kind of Borealis-like. And then on the normal settings over here, you can adjust the size. And then I might want to center those just so they look nice. And that's kind of a cool effect that fits the page. Having those bigger makes it easier for mobile users to tap those buttons. And now that's the most important thing on the page. They can find your other social channels and find more content, and you can grow your audience that way. On top of that, say maybe instead of just the social channels where the audience is kind of mine, but not really mine, and even in some cases you have to pay to reach them, maybe I want to build my own audience on here. And maybe since your link in bio page is actually a site and it has other features to it, and you maybe want to start a blog or something on the other side of it, you can drop a subscription form right at the top of your page to start growing like an email audience. This is built into our platform so that every time you create a new post and publish it, your subscribers will get that post as an email, and they can read it from their inbox, or they can click through and read it on your site. But they'll get it every single time, like a newsletter, and you don't really have to do anything else to make it work. This subscription has a bunch of different styling options as well, and there's also different subscription patterns you can pull from if you want to. But that's another really good option to kind of grow your audience with the LinkedIn bio page. So let's say you're not big on the audience growth, or maybe you have a big audience already and it has been growing. And let's say maybe you want to focus on displaying your work. So maybe your buttons are important. You want to grow your traffic. Your links to your profiles are important. You want to grow your audience, but you also want to do more, which is totally fine. So under these buttons, I'm going to go ahead and add a little spacer. And you can do this in other ways, but that just gives me a gap to control how close together the buttons are to the next thing I add. The next thing I add is actually going to be a gallery. So if I'm an artist, I paint, I draw, I do digital art, I create art with AI, whatever it is, I might want to display some of that. I'm going to use a gallery. And so the gallery, I can choose multiple images. And like I mentioned earlier, I can use the Pexels integration and just pick a bunch from another site for the sake of this demo. If you're the artist, obviously you wouldn't do that. You'd want to upload your own art and display it that way. I'm just going to pick some random cloud images since that's what it gave me. And again, it's automatically going to pull these into my site. It's going to put them into the gallery, and then I can customize how that looks. So if somebody comes to this LinkedIn bio page and they're looking at my links and they check out my other content, or they're considering checking out my other content, they can just simply scroll down and see what kind of art I create. I get a sense for whether or not it's what they're looking for, or if they want to check it out, or maybe even someday buy it. As I mentioned, the gallery has its own options for how you want to style, how big you want the images, if you want a background color on it, if you want them tight together like that, or if you want them further apart. I kind of like when they're pretty close together, so I'll leave it that way. And then you can actually link the entire gallery to your store or something that you have online, which is pretty cool. You can choose to crop the images automatically to fit that grid. You can choose how many columns you want them in. It's pretty easy to use and it's pretty automatic. So you just choose a few basic things and upload your photos and you're good to go. So those are the top things. If you're building an audience, you're trying to get more plays or views to specific content, you're trying to display your artwork, or you just want your page to pop a little bit more. There's a lot more you can do with styles in terms of making your design stand out and kind of personalizing a little bit more. And there's more you can do with photos and editing. We have a ton of videos that cover those type of things on our YouTube. So be sure to check it out and subscribe, because we put a lot more content out on a regular basis. If you have any requests, feel free to comment and let us know what you're looking for, and we can get those out to you as well.